Hello, everybody. Welcome to this episode of Paleo Fridays. This is a special episode. I know I said that last time because of the holidays, but this one's really special because it is the last episode of Paleo Fridays for the year for 2022. This is being recorded on December 30th, Friday. It's going to be a great episode. We are going to be discussing what I believe are some of the top paleoanthropological discoveries of 2022. Of course, there were so many big announcements and discoveries that choosing these was really difficult, and there was really no logical way of doing this. I just picked what I thought was the most interesting. Many people could agree or disagree, but these are the stories that I thought was most interesting. So we're just going to quickly recap these. And you can view them as well as more information about each specific discovery on my website. I'll put the link in the description, but be sure to check it out because there were some really amazing discoveries. And everyone's coming out with their articles right now. Top discoveries in anthropology in 2022, top discoveries in science 2022. Check them all out. They're all awesome. Compare them. But I just want to give you an idea of what mine is and show off some cool things. So, in no particular order, we have got starting with the Red Deer Cave people. For those of you who don't know, these are a group of hominins that were found in a cave, the Red Deer Cave, in China, and their morphology was a little strange. It was odd. People didn't know exactly what they were, if they were modern Homo sapiens or an off branch or something different. But what we have discovered is that they are modern Homo sapiens. They are not a different subspecies. They are not anything else. They are us. And we discovered this through DNA analysis, so it's pretty rock solid. And now we know. So on to the next story is we have the Sterkfontein cave redating. And what happened was the Sterkfontein caves are found in South Africa, and they have been a home to a plethora of discoveries of new species and of fossils, including this one right here, which we know as Mrs. Ples. She was discovered, although now we think it might be a he in Sterkfontein. And it was originally dated to around 2 million years ago. We thought this was about 2 million years old. But new dating techniques have shown that they were actually about closer to 4 million years old, showing that East Africa was not the home specifically of these hominins at that time point, but they were also in South Africa as well. So that's a pretty big story, the redating of the Sterkfontein caves. Next on our little list here is we have the discovery of the oldest face in Europe. And what this is was a 1.4 million year old discovery of a partial facial bone of a Homo antecessor, which is a species we know almost nothing about, that was possibly our common ancestor with Homo heidelbergensis or basal Neanderthals, Neanderthals and Denisovans. We don't know, we're not sure, but this was found in Europe, in Cima del Elefante, which is part of the Cima de los Huesos cave system. And it was found below where the previously most oldest face was found, a part, or if not face, but a partial cranium was found right above in a layer above it. But now we have what we now call the oldest face in Europe, dating to 1.4 million years ago. So this is pretty big. We know that hominins were in Europe at this time, and they were much older to than what we first believed. So then we also move on to the next item on our list, which is the most senior signs of humans in the Americas. Now, for many researchers, the peopling of the Americas is a great and compelling mystery. For decades now, we've wondered whether they've come from the Bering Strait or whether the Silurians crossed the Atlantic. There's been a plethora of ideas, but now there's been a new find in the White Sands National Park. And now I know what you're thinking, this has already been debunked, but I don't think it has been. I don't think there's been enough dating on the actual site to prove or disprove whether these fossilized human footprints dating to 24 to 29,000 years ago are accurate or true. What it would mean, though, is that we came across the Bering Strait, the Bering Land Bridge, much earlier, or possibly another land bridge, much earlier than first believed. And this would change a lot about what we know about the peopling of the Americas, going all the way down to South America, and of course across to the western United States. This was found in White Sands National Park, New Mexico, at 24,000 years ago. So, as you can imagine, the arrival of indigenous peoples in the Americas would have occurred much earlier than that for them to be in New Mexico at that point. Although we do move quite quickly when we're migrating. So those dates are up for debate and it's quite a controversial topic, but we'll have to see what future data shows. Now, the next item on the list is my personal favorite, and it is again, it's controversial only because the data has not yet been presented due to the papers being held up in the publication process, and it's an ongoing thing. But the preprints are, well, they're what the items are, and it's pretty hard to argue with it. And what I'm talking about, of course, is Homo naledi and their use of fire. Now, Homo naledi, as we all should know, is a species found in the Rising Star Cave system in South Africa, discovered by Lee Berger's team and analyzed by him for the last almost, well, 10 years actually, now that we're coming to 2013. It was first discovered in 2013. I meant 2023, of course. So it's been 10 years since we've known about Homo naledi, and we now have evidence. Or the evidence has been announced for charcoal, for hearths where fire was maintained, for burned tiny animal bones, and for basically every passageway at every corridor, at every junction, there would be a fire. And thus, we now know how Homo naledi made their way through these dark and dangerous tunnels without light. Well, they had light, they had fire. And one of the most interesting things that I find is in some of the chambers where we find remains of Homo naledi, there are hearths and signs of ash and fire, but there are no animal remains. But in areas where they were just traveling, there are animal remains. So there was a distinction in where the fires would and should be made and what their purposes were, which I think is an exceptionally high sign of rationality and forward and arbitrary thinking, more than we saying just having the fires themselves, which we know other species have had much earlier than Homo naledi. The first fires date back to 1.5 million years ago with Homo erectus, so it's not completely out of the mind and idea that Homo naledi would have fire, but it's just up for debate on exactly how and what was going on. But that was a huge announcement that came very late in the year. It was only a few weeks ago, so it's definitely up and popular in what's going on right now. And of course, we have Neo here, who is the one of the finer examples of Homo naledi, based on his skeleton, which was almost complete compared to the others. He is a male, and this is his almost complete skull. Give it a good look around. So this guy, even with his small brain, which we are thinking was much more advanced than we previously thought based on endocasts, was lighting fires, was burying its dead. Well, I won't say bury, was interring its dead in a locality that was made specifically for the deceased, since we're not using the word buried yet. That is a strong connotation that I don't think Professor Berger is ready to use yet. But I personally think we're getting to that point where there's almost nothing else to say that they did. And the final discovery or announcement that we'll be talking about is involving Tumai, who has been on and off our oldest bipedal ancestor. He dates to about 7 million years ago, and new data from analyzing postcranial remains is showing that he was indeed bipedal. Now, this is going against a paper that came out last year showing the exact opposite, that based on different postcranial remains, he was not bipedal. But based on the skull and where the foramen magnum is located and these postcranial remains, many scientists are still debating whether Sahelanthropus tridensis or Tumai was a biped or a quadruped. And honestly, I don't know if we ever will know, especially with how the fossils are being locked up and treated. There's very little access to them. So we'll just have to wait and see. But for the latest on Tumai, he is bipedal once again and is holding the title of our oldest bipedal ancestor within Africa. And now that was a lot, and there were plenty of more discoveries, big, big discoveries. But I also wanted to take a moment to thank and honor the people who we lost this year. Because there were some big names, and I'm not aware of all of them, that we lost in 2022. To name a few who were leading names in our industry, we lost Richard Leakey, we lost Yves Coppens, Bill Kimble, Kimoya Kimu. We've lost so many big people, and I just want to give a shout out to their families and wish them that they find solace and peace in what has happened this year, and know that their loved ones' contributions have made a mark on the world forevermore. And I hope that we can all take a moment to thank them and for their contributions. And I think that's about it for this episode of Paleo Fridays. And again, this is the last one for the year. I don't know if there probably won't be any more videos until next year. So I will see you guys. I know it's exciting. We've got the new year coming. I hope it's going to be a great one. In fact, I know it's going to be a great one for the world of paleoanthropology and for anthropology in general. We've got so much coming up. It's going to be great. I'll see you all in the new year. Have a great and safe celebration. See you guys. Peace.